mostly excited. Got the squash and the onions and shallots in the oven. Hi everyone, my name is Maddie Coppel and I'm the new food editor at The Blade, and this is our very first Meals with Maddie here at DeRocher's Kitchen. And I'm making a fall transitional dish to winter, a butternut squash pasta with crispy pancetta. And we start by taking a butternut squash and peeling it. And then you want to dice it into roughly large cubes, place that on a baking tray, and then you'll take a shallot, slice that in half and half again, and you'll put that on the tray as well with about 4 to 6 peeled garlic cloves, and you'll drizzle on some olive oil, about 1/4 cup, sprinkle that with salt and pepper, and roast it in a 400 degree oven for about 25 to 30 minutes until the butternut squash is tender and soft and the garlic and the shallots are just lightly caramelized. So while the squash is roasting in the oven, you can get started on your crispy pancetta. You want about 4 ounces of pancetta and you're gonna crisp that up in a saute pan for about 5 to 7 minutes. And then when the squash is done, put all of those ingredients from the tray into a blender. I've added salt and pepper to taste.
Red pepper flakes.
So that's optional if you like it spicy.
Nutmeg. And heavy cream.
And blend that all together until you get a nice creamy sauce. So when your pasta's al dente, you wanna strain it, but be sure to reserve about 1 cup of pasta water in case you wanna thin the sauce out later to make it luxurious and all creamy together. And I used bucatini noodles for this dish because I like the little holes on either end because it kind of sucks in all the great creamy pasta sauce. Then you're gonna add that nice creamy orange sauce from your blender right into that pasta. All right, so you're gonna take your kitchen tweezers, get a nice hold on some pasta. You're gonna take it, keeping them closed, wind it up a few times. And you're gonna take it over to your dish, slowly, and taking the pasta off. And then you top it with either pecorino cheese or Parmesan. My preference is Parmesan. And then you can also top it with a little bit of parsley just for a little added color. So I love this dish because it really brings me back to the time I studied in Perugia, Italy. And that's really what I wanted to capture in my first Meals with Maddie. Pasta is my favorite food of all time, so of course I had to make one of my favorites for my first episode. Creamy, it's crispy with the pancetta on top, it's just the perfect amount of being salty, a little sweet from the butternut, and it's one of my favorite dishes to transition into winter. My lunch is good today. Ta-da!
Fantastic.
We've done it. Help yourself.
We done did it. Good job, man.
Yay, thanks. Thank you guys so much for watching the first episode of Meals with Maddie here at DeRocher's, and I'll see you the first Sunday of every month.